Hello and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now leaving the town of Trim. Or maybe not. Men's voice? Okay, plural. That would be correct with man's voice. If it's men's voice, the single quote, I forget what you even call that, would go after the S, but anyway. Hey you, wait! Gary says, I finally found you. Kiaz says, return the things you stole from us. I guess they're confusing us with that gang, those evil bards who are around somewhere. McBain says, what are you talking about? It's not polite to speak to strangers like that. Don't play dumb, says Gary. I know you're the swing gang. Yeah, now I remember the name, they helped me remember. The swing gang, says Una. I won't let you escape this time. Stumbles over his words, Kiaz says. Forte says, let me go. It's some kind of misunderstanding. What the hell? Who are you guys? Says Gary. A mysterious man says, it's not admirable. Adult men gang up and bully an elderly person and children. I always think they're kids. I think everyone is kids, unless they have white hair, like the mysterious man or like the old people. We are the ones who are bullied by them, says Kiaz. Do you know what the swing gang did to us? The man says, calm down. Look at them. How can an elderly person, a boy, a girl, and a dog be the swing gang? Don't forget the cat. They carry musical instruments, Gary says. We didn't see them personally because we weren't here. But they say that the swing gang disguised themselves as troubadours. Oh, disguised, so they're not real troubadours. I kind of like the whole evil bard idea, though. The musical instruments are proof that they are the swing gang in disguise. I have a musical instrument myself, says the man. He plays his accordion. Kia says, that means you're also members of the swing gang? A mysterious woman with green hair says, you're so simple. How can a beautiful girl like me be a thief? But I understand why you've become suspicious about my father. You haven't seen the beautiful women who are thieves in the other Legend of Heroes games. I forget her name. I'm thinking of the bandit leader from, I believe it's, Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. The man says, how can you say such a thing to your own father? The woman says, have you seen the sketch of the swing gang? Kiaz says, of course we have. There are 5 members in a swing gang. That's right, says Gary. 1 ringleader with a beard and 4 henchmen. So count 5 for me, the woman says. We have an old man with silver hair, 2 children, one of whom is a girl. Kia says, hey, Gary, we may have made a mistake. If you say so, they don't match the description. The children alerted us by saying it's the swing gang, so I guess we weren't thinking logically, says Gary. The man says, how dare you call an old person and helpless children villains? Excuse me, we're not helpless. I'm sorry, says Gary. Now that you know it's a misunderstanding, please go home. Well, I knew you would come, says the man. It's about time. Master, it's been a while. It's been a while, says Forte. Una says, do you know Grandpa Mac? Of course. My name is Shao. I'm a kind accordionist. Oh, didn't we hear about him? I have traveled many times with the master. McBain? So why did he not recognize you? You simply followed me against my will, McBain says. Please, don't be so harsh. But of course, harsh words are an expression of love. You haven't changed a bit, McBain. I'm Rachel, says the woman. I look nothing like my father, don't I? I'm glad I didn't take after him. I think you have his hair. Watch your language, says Shao. Morte says at least they have the same personality. I'm Una. Nice to meet you. I'm Forte. How do you do? McBain says, by the way, Shao, I must thank you for finding Leon's book. Right, he's the one who found the book for him right in the beginning. You were looking for it for a long time. I was always conscious of it while traveling. Did the book make you dance with joy? On our way, we happened to meet this guy who had it. When I told him about you, he was deeply moved and gave it to me for free. We had work to do ourselves, and we didn't know when we were going to see you. That's why I used a courier. Anyway, Master. The swing gang those guys were talking so emotionally about. Rachel says, it's become a kind of phenomenon around here. They disguise themselves as troubadours and sing a mysterious song to put the audience to sleep. Then they steal any valuables from the unconscious audience. They put people to sleep with music? Shao says, thanks to them, we've been treated like criminals. We can't perform around here. Please help us, Master. I see, says McBain. That's certainly not a favorable situation. Right? Rachel says, people in Trim are extra suspicious. A sight of a stranger makes them alert. Shao says, so the kind accordionist has an idea. We just met a young entertainment manager who was also left in the cold for the same reason. We want to give a soulful performance for the people in this town to make them forget about the fearful memories of the swing gang. We sort of hit it off talking about the idea. But we can't do it alone, says Rachel. We need more people to back us up. Shao says, we were wondering if you could help us. Musical prodigies Forte and Una, and of course, you, Master. Do you know about us? Asks Forte. The passengers on the stomach told me about how you cured their seasickness. You even got the second prize at the recital in Pinzel, right? Wow! Rachel clapping hands. The second prize winner! Forte is at a loss for words. You're too obvious, says McBain. Grandpa, we should help them. Una goes, Forte? He actually fell for that. Forte says, we can't let people retain a bad image of performers because of the swing gang. We must do something. Shao says, wow, what a gallant spirit you have. You're truly the grandson of McBain. Master, you have such a good grandson. Tears welled up in my eyes. McBain says, whatever your motive is, we can't turn a blind eye. That's my master. You're greater than the president. Now it's been decided. I'll take you to Bruce the entertainment manager. Rachel says, he's waiting for us at the outdoor stage. Oh, that guy. Shao says, let's go. Quick, master. Shao and Rachel join the party. Wow. Oof. Six people. Who can keep track of them all? Now, from what I've read, you can only have four people in battle for some reason. Select a character. Who has healing? We can't take out Jian. Oh wait. Oh, I see. The swords under the LV level thingy shows who will be in battle. Alright, so for the next battle we have Forte, McBain, Shao, and Rachel. Who knows if I'm gonna like that arrangement. But we can switch it back, I guess, after every battle, right? So. Okay, so Shao is a finishing move. Megaton Hammer. Okay, they use the hammer. We saw this last episode. They have hammers and daggers in the the weapon shop, and no one can use them. So we found our hammer and dagger, people. A deadly blow with a hammer. And then for skills, loud laughter. Angers the enemy to become the target. That's funny. And then Rachel, for finishing move, has howling voice. Unhuman-like high-frequency voice damages the enemy. And then skills, she has wink. Even the enemy is taken in and stops moving. And blowing kiss. A passionate blowing kiss that enthralls the enemy. How could blowing a kiss be passionate, though? Alright, anything else? Equipment. Okay, so Shao has that tacky hammer. Take hammer. Artist clothes. Need to get him with some better stuff. Rachel has the throw dagger and artist clothes. Let me just see if he has anything new. Doll Knight 3 we bought last time. Okay. Now I'm just worn around, see if anyone says anything different. He says the same thing. Let's get some new weapons and stuff. So they don't know healing. That's the problem. Healing doesn't seem to be like a common thing you can do in this game. Okay, so we can buy her the Skylark Dagger, which will increase her defense by 1 and her attack by 7. And then we can buy this guy the Thorn Hammer, which makes people cry. Attack goes up by 8, and defense up by 1. No one else can use a shield. Shao and Rachel could both use leather armor. The Thorn Hammer. And the leather armor. Defense going up by 5. Same here. And the Skylark Dagger. Yeah. 7 more attack, 1 more defense. Anything else here? No. Now we'll sell this other crap. Throw dagger. Take hammer. Artist clothes. Alright, we still have over 1,000 gents. Not bad at all. Did I even talk to these people in here? I don't know if I talked to these two. Are these the two who are accosting us outside? They don't say anything new. Kia says, first, the swing gang disguises themselves as troubadours just like you. As they sing, the audience mysteriously falls asleep and then they take away the money. Wow, we have to learn their technique. But not to take away people's money. Unless they're bad people. I'm sorry we mistook you for the swing gang, but the truth is, even if we know you have nothing to do with them, the sight of troubadours makes us nervous. I hope you understand how we feel. No, we do not understand anything. You are a mockery of a human being. Alright, let's go out. Anything new going in here? Yo, the old lady moves around. Quickly. Your wife is old, I'm sorry. Alright, eh, nobody's saying anything new around here, so let's go talk to... Ooh, I'm gonna go down in there, look at that. So mysterious. Yeah. Just looking around for this stage. Greetings! Hey, Shao. How's it going? As you said, we're now making posters. How about you, Shao? What happened to the child Kathara, a prodigy? Wait, what happened to the child Kathara prodigy you were talking about? Tatan! You're looking at him. This is Forte. Is this supposed to be like, ta-da? prodigy, Forte says. I don't think so. Don't be so humble. That's great. We can now hold a concert worthy of the name of Merito's Group. Merito's Group. McBain says, the Merito's Group? I know. A company headquartered in Cavaro and Marcheros. That's correct. We are a large entertainment company having a wide network throughout Weltluna, or so we thought. But now, even with our name, people don't trust performers. I'm fed up with the swing gang. It looks like everyone in this town loathes every piece of music and every artist. Don't be disheartened, says Shao. We now have Forte the Prodigy, so we can give a great concert. You're right. I must think about the direction, so can I hear your performance? Of course. As a warm-up, you know. Let's go. We heard Let's Dance last time. I do like the I'm Fine. I think out of all these, I like I'm Fine the best. It's a jaunty jig. Dog is moving very quickly. That's how we keep him in such good shape. You guys should put out chairs, not just these, whatever these are, blankets, tiles. Shao says, yay! Clapping. Thank you very much. You're not part of the audience, Shao. It was a wonderful performance. And then he whistles. Huh? What's wrong? Are you so moved you're at a loss for words? No, well, I don't know how to say it. You didn't like our performance, did you? Says Rachel. Well, what I'm trying to say is... McBain says, what you're trying to say is that it lacks something. It's not that the performance was bad or anything. If this is a regular concert, I have nothing to complain about. But this time, our aim is to clear the names of all performers around the world. It's not about skills. We need to give them an eye-opening experience. This concert has a lofty ambition. To pluck the heartstrings of people, we need some extra touch. We need a spice that adds an inspiration. A spice, says Shao. McBain says, you're such a professional entertainment manager. I like the way you approach your job seriously. Bruce, give us some time. We'll take some time and think about what we can do. That's a good idea, says Shao. We may come up with an impactful phrase or something. We'll look for clues that will add a spice to our performance. Let's walk around in search of a spice. Okay, gotta find a spice. This is not the land of Dune. I'll think about it too. So I also ask you, please think about ways to make this work. Yeah, a little demanding, aren't you? Can we add a spice to our performance? Oh, we need to talk to her. We need to talk to all of them. Both of them. Okay, I guess he doesn't know anything. Well, we have to talk to them, but they don't say anything new. Get me out of my way, sign. Yo! Yo! Ku says, God, it's a swing gang. What are you doing, like dancing or something? Lin says, don't come near me. I hate the swing gang. You're not no stinking swing gang. There's a fisherman around here. I don't think he'd say anything new, but we have to check. No, we're not fishing too. Are you planning a concert in this town? I understand how you feel, but I'm sorry. You can't find any audience. We'll find them. We'll find them. There's a strange cave south of this town. There's an image of an eye drawn on the ground. A rumor has it that there's some hidden treasure underneath. Of course, many monsters inhabit the cave, so it's safer to stay away. An image of an eye. First, a swing gang disguises themselves as troubadours just like you. Yeah, we read that already. I heard a rumor. In the cave south from here, there's a... What was the name? An eye? Oh, anyway, there's this mysterious stone called something, but no one can get to the place where the stone is. Okay, sounds promising. No one in here. Okay. Shao says, I'm lost. You can't just come up with an idea just like that. You need something fun and exciting, and ideas will naturally come up. Something exciting, says Rachel. Oh, I remembered. There's a cave south of this town. Would you like to go there for a change? Adventure! That sounds fun, says Shao. Rachel says, we can't think up good ideas staying in a depressing town. You're right. We're going then. Let's go. Okay. I'm not done looking around. I think we might have talked to everybody. Yeah. Alright, let's go check out that cave then. Monsoon Road. Is this a place to break through with our rock thing? No? I see if you had McBain. Well, he... That's right. The three of them are with us no matter what. Except for when we're in combat. I guess the others just stand around and... like, cheer or something. Just trying to eliminate some possibilities here. Let's see. Oh, that's a spooky looking tree. At least this cave is south. Viento's south as well. Oh, wow. Look at that hole. The hole in the world. It's a friendly monster. Jumping squirrel of phantom jelly? Oh, clay jelly. Wait. What was this other thing that I can't seem to get to? We can't target it. That's weird. Okay. I don't want to hurt the cute squirrel. That's a throwing dagger. One clay jelly down. Here you go, Shao says. Well, that thing could definitely hit us. We can't target it. Wonder what we have to do. If this was Baldur's Gate, I'd be casting like a sea invisibility, kind of invisibility purge or something like that. But, well, this is definitely not Baldur's Gate. Here, she says. She killed that one. We killed that squirrel, poor thing. Phantom thing he missed. Clay thing he missed. Wow. No valid targets. And this helps allies only. Draws the enemy's attention to become the target. I don't think that's... no. I want it to become the target. Well, there's gotta be a strategy for this. Switch? Oh, I could switch out. That's cool. So a good strategy for, like, boss battles is to have everyone as possible with finishing moves, like, ready. Switch them out. Unless switching them out clears that. Wait. Oh, I can wait over there? Increases power. Not gonna help. Loud laughter. Angers the enemy to become the target. No, okay. Even the enemy is taken in and stops moving. I don't remember it saying exactly that. No targets. No targets. Oh, cool. Phantom. Oh, wait. It's... I can't wait on the enemy, I guess. Aim well. Raises critical attack, care, restores HP slightly. Huh. Switch. For Jan. So if Jan can't do anything, we'll just have to escape the battle. I expect that, he won't be able to. So he's got healing. Hunting for enemy items and roaring. Damn. Alright. Oh, okay. They all escape. What? No! We were able to get away. I didn't think we'd be able to. Oh, nice! In here, maybe items that can help with phantom things. Lapis lazuli. That's a kind of gem. Leash bottle M. Okay, there's a medium mana cure. Oh, the other side of the chest. You found an orb of Ocean 36 on the floor. Wow, you really need to thoroughly examine these chests. A marble with an image of Rachel. I thought it said 34. No? Rachel Normal. Okay. One of many gemstones you can sell to shops. Blue jewelry with a metallic shine. You haven't sold any of them yet. And of course I get another leash bottle M. That's pretty awesome, I think. So I'm guessing that this whole phantom thing is like... we'll be able to deal with them better later. We'll have some kind of method of dealing with them. Maybe this stone that we're gonna find helps reveal, like, invisible creatures or something.